Finglas, a suburb seated on the skirttails of Dublin City, is a neighbourhood that has often drawn negative attention from the media. Its people are working class. Its forefathers settled in the area after the Great War. They came with new struggles and oral tales of Dublin's inner city, the poor, and the political resolution to the housing problem of that time. Their children would see a different city. They would rise from this neighborhood and go on and impact not only the nation, but the world. People like Bono, Googie, Gavin Friday. Footballers like Stephen Kelly, Ronnie Whelan, as well as writers Dermot Bulger and George Fitzgerald. Not forgetting Brendan O'Carroll, Christy Dignam, Aslan, the D11 Runners, that 90s hit band that inspired not only a book, but an Alan Parker film. And of course, Eurovision winner Niamh Kavanagh and soap stars like Tommy Tormey. This, however, is not a story of national or international stars. This is a simple story of ordinary men and their will to go into the drug world carrying a message of the cross. It is also a tale of lives being empowered for the good and the witness of how that power reached across the city. This is a Finglas story of faith and hope, a story of transformation.
They say there's a book in everybody. The question is, where do you start? I suppose at the beginning. For me, we stated this way. In the opening chapter of the book, When We Are Kids, said William Street, 2004. In 2004, we'd reached the grand old age of 40. At that moment, my feet had taken me from building sites to unemployment to a shack in a car park no bigger than a shoebox. After becoming unemployed, my father got me a job. The work description entailed sitting in a shack looking after other people's cars. The shack was 8x4, old and worn, like something you'd only find in a Dickens novel. Severance pay for a wonderful childhood, a runaway youth, and a less than brilliant time in academia. There were four walls and time and loads of it. Not forgetting the large window where I view the world. Now, when the only companion you have is time, you can draw it out like a long dying breath. It can take you by the hand and lead you to many places you don't want to go. The first stop is boredom. And this is where I began to write, to scroll down memories, photographs, conceptual thoughts in the opening chapter of the book, When We Are Kids.
benefit the D11 Runners.
D11 Runners and
known as
the D11 Runners!
D11 Runners!
His life, you'll think it's what most of us would experience in many lifetimes. He's a former champion boxer.
He's sharp, competitive, but I wouldn't like to get be on the end of one of his punches anyway. So,
a successful musician and now an emerging author. So,
is an author, but he's going to be telling you about his story, how he got to become a brilliant author who has now got a best-selling book.
I would put the D11 Runners down as the best dance band in the country. Oh,
Jesus. Jesus children, Jesus not you, Jesus children, hello children, Jesus not you, America.
Are you hearing what he's saying? Are you feeling what you're praying? Are you hearing and praying what you say inside? Yeah.
The twins were born in Dublin's inner city in 1964, in what was then St. Kevin's Hospital. They were richly blessed from infancy, being ushered into a culture of not only the written word, but of storytelling, and their family was connected to some individuals who were intellectually gifted. In 1966, the Fitzgeralds moved to Ballymun. Now, Ballymun was, at the time of its development, a diverse departure from other corporation housing projects. It was Europe's biggest development at that time. In December of 1968, Mr. Neil Blaney, the Minister for Agriculture then, put the last prefab unit in position.